Good morning, children. Today I am going to explain matter around us. Already in the last class, I gave some introduction about the your physical science chapters. Today I am going to explain some topics belongs to matter around us. First of all, once again I will explain what is matter. Matter means what? Matter is any substance which has some mass and occupies some space. Any substance, whatever it may be, it has some mass. Some mass should be there and it should occupy some space. Then it is called as matter. Matter means any substance which has mass and occupies some space. And for example, a book. Book is the matter. And water is also matter. Anything, whatever it may be, mass containing objects is called as matter. Now, today I am going to explain about some topic diffusion. Diffusion. This is in our matter around the chapter diffusion. What is diffusion? Diffusion means spreading of gas. Spreading of gas one place to another place. Spreading of gas one place to another place is called diffusion. In our daily life, we are observing so many phenomena, diffusions. At kitchen, if you go to kitchen, mother some nice food, nice dish, you will get smell. That is due to diffusion. And if you temple, their incense sticks smell is there. That is also called diffusion. Diffusion means spreading one place to another place. In our textbook, one lab activity is given about the diffusion. You can open your textbook and see the lab activity. Here, diffusion means spreading of gas from one place to another place. So this is called diffusion. Spreading of gas from one place to another place is called diffusion. In your textbook, one lab activity is given. You can open your textbook and see that lab activity. You have to take 1 meter cube. 1 meter cube you have to take, and you take two cartons. One you have to dip in the HCl, dilute HCl. Another one you have to dip in the NH3, ammonia. HCl and ammonia, that you have to place two corners. Here this side you have to place HCl carton, this side ammonia carton, NH3. And you have to close with rubber cork. You have to close with rubber corks. These two are rubber corks. You have to close it. And after some time, reaction takes place in the test tube. Reaction takes place in the test tube and it forms ammonium chloride. That is NH4Cl. NH4Cl. Ammonium chloride is formed, and that is in the form of white ring. White color ring is formed, that is towards the HCl. Towards the HCl, white ring is formed. This side, a white ring. White ring is formed. This is due to reaction between HCl and NH3. Ammonium chloride is formed. A white ring is formed. This is towards the HCl. Towards the HCl meaning is the diffusion of NH3 is more. Diffusion is more. NH3 is more. HCl is lesser. NH3 traveled more distance. HCl traveled less distance. So by this understand the diffusion of HCl or NH3 is more than HCl. Why? Because this is due to densities. The NH3 density is lesser, HCl density is more. So this phenomena, this action is called diffusion. Diffusion means spreading of gas from one place to another place is called diffusion. And one more topic is states properties of solid, liquid and gases. Properties of solids, liquids and gases. So what are the properties? Solid means it has particular shape is there, shape, and it has volume also there, shape and volume. It has definite shape and volume. Solids have definite shape and definite volume. Oh, this is the solid. For example, this duster is the solid. It has some shape is there. This is the particular shape of the duster and it has some volume. Means length, breadth, height. So duster have shape and volume. So this duster is called as solid and liquids means it has no shape and volume also particular volume is not there, but container means if you pour in 1 liter jug, it is the shape is 1 liter or any curved shape, that container, the shape is the curved, so it is the container volume. And last one, gas, no shape, no value. There is no shape and no value also particularly not there. So these are the properties of solids, liquids and gases. Solids have definite shape and definite value. And liquids, no shape and container volume. And gases, no shape, no value. This is about properties of solids, liquids and gases. So children, follow the online classes and you have to go through the textbook and this online class and develop your knowledge. Thank you.